Right, with a cut tie, here we go. On Tuesday, shocking news emerged. A 67-year-old man had died after being treated in a makeshift tent in a hospital parking lot in Pietermaritzburg. Some hospital officials have been suspended, but is that really enough? Let's speak to KwaZulu-Natal Premier Sihle Zikalala. Premier, thanks for your time. We appreciate it. My question to you is simple. Would you allow a member of your family to be treated in a tent?
Hello?
Premier, can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you.
All right, so here's the question, Premier. Would you allow a member of your family to be treated in a tent?
To be treated in?
A tent.
Well, not. I think we need to understand what happened. A tent was not meant for treatment, according to our understanding. But that's where they were getting tested as they arrive and then be taken inside the hospital. That's why, as the government, we have taken the decision to suspend those who were involved in this matter. And that's why we are saying it was not acceptable, it shouldn't have happened, and we have acted decisive.
Premier, one of your main responsibilities is to ensure the dignity of patients, but you failed to do that. So what do you have to say about that?
I think you are generalizing. You take something where there are specific people who are employed to do that. You then want us to say we failed to do that. People who have failed are those who have been already suspended, are already facing music. And then if you say we have failed or I have failed personally, you seem to be misconstruing the question.
No, I'm very clear with my question. You have an oversight role as Premier of the province.
No. Can I please speak? Give me a right to respond to your question.
Okay, go ahead.
Yes. If there is someone as a person who has a right to provide an oversight, if there is someone who's not doing his work or her work, we act and act decisively with no fear or favor. There is no one who will let a person not getting a treatment in an appropriate manner who will not be attended to. And we will always set a standard of a fair and just government. We have a responsibility to treat our people with dignity. We have a responsibility to care. And there are those who are employed to be in each and every hospital and facilities, because one cannot be all over.
So the health minister says you're not running out of hospital space, right? So why then was this patient moved outside for treatment?
That is what we are investigating, because that hospital, as we are informed right now, seems to have not reached full occupancy rate in terms of beds. And that's what, as government, we have to ensure. We must ensure that there is bed availability, and we must ensure that there is staff with equipment, including PPEs and everything. But in this regard, they had all of that, yet they treated a person in the tent. And that's why we've taken a decision to suspend those who are involved.
But you suspended officials from the hospital, right? But what action are you taking against the MEC for Health, for instance, for allowing this to happen? Because we keep saying we're suspending people involved, but you do have oversight roles.
Let's be specific. The person who has effected the instruction to suspend is the MEC herself, because the MEC would have not allowed this thing to happen.
She did allow it because it happened.
No, she didn't allow it. It is not her, the officials who acted, employed by the department. If you want to take that approach, why you don't say, fire the MEC, fire the HOD, fire the chief directorate, and all others till that manager of the hospital?
Well, you must are the public how officials
no, no, no,
represent
no, no,
these
no, no,
departments
please.
And people.
Please give me an opportunity to set the record straight.
I'm letting you speak. Make your point.
Yes, I'm making a point here. There is a management of the hospital. and there is a management of this division, and these are people who are already suspended by the department, we will always act with no fear. We are not going to be selective. We are not going to give anyone preferential treatment. We will be fair. A person who acts irresponsible is the one who will face the music.
So when does your administration or you start to face the music for letting this happen in the province? Because you are leading the fight against COVID-19 in your province. That's your task as premier right now, right?
No. But this is not going to... No. Look, you know what? You must be able to understand what you are saying. This has happened in a particular hospital. On behalf of government, I have apologized. On behalf of government, I've issued an instruction to the mini MEC to act. And the MEC accordingly has acted and suspended the two managers involved in this. And we will always ensure that all public servants are empowered to work, but those who are not doing their work are facing the music.
On another note, Premier, with at least 30 million rand in PPE corruption in your province, why is it so easy, it seems, for criminals to operate under your watch?
We've since acted on that. We got the report. We decided decisively. It was me who instituted the investigation. I also presented the report. I took the report to the MEC and I said, act, and the MEC have suspended those people. And we're going to ensure that the disciplinary process is swift, fair, and transparent. Decisive actions will be taken.
Premier, didn't the president make it clear to all people who are in different provinces in the nation that he did not want corruption, especially when it came to PPEs and PPE tenders? But that has happened. So you failed to carry out that responsibility.
That's why I have carried the responsibility to always ensure that all departments firstly follow the lines. And even after that, we have instituted a process where there is now a pre-audit before the award is done. But this happened at the beginning. And that's why we've imposed these sanctions. And we will be decisive in uprooting corruption. Corruption is not what we stand for. It's an antithesis of what we stand for as KwaZulu-Natal government. Corruption is against the values and traditions of the ANC, which have mandated us. And those who have done so individually will have to face music.
Why do you not face the music? Because it happens under your watch.
It happened under my watch. No, you are totally wrong. And your
Sorry. Who's the premier of KZN? Who has the oversight role?
Wait. You are totally misconstruing the truth. And I would like to respond to issues fairly. I would like to have time to respond to issues fairly. I have acted. I'm not running the department. Neither the MEC. I am in charge of policy development, monitoring the implementation of the policy. There is a person who is in charge of overseeing the administration in a form of HOD. There are people below HOD, and all people who have been found wanting by the report are now facing the music. And if the report reveals anyone, that person will need to face the music, irrespective of his standing or the position he occupies.
Sounds very easy. So given the corruption scandals in your province, given that a 67-year-old man has died because he was moved for treatment to a makeshift tent outside a hospital, I mean, do you think that you're not failing the people of KwaZulu-Natal?
Let me tell you right now, in as far as COVID-19, because you are coming here with conceived ideas, I'm not going to fall into your trap. In KwaZulu-Natal, we've managed to build hospitals that were going to be built, infrastructure that was going to be built 3 years from now. We've managed to do that openly. In KwaZulu-Natal, we have taken a decision that all tenders that have been allocated through COVID period will be made public. All those tenders will also be subjected to scrutiny and we have called for SIU to investigate. So we are dealing with corruption. But in KwaZulu-Natal, we are recording the recovery rate of more than 60% of people who are infected with COVID-19. We are ensuring that those people are treated and getting supported.
How are you dealing with corruption when there's corruption that's happened to the amount of 30 million rand?
Wait, let me finish, please. In KwaZulu-Natal, we are ensuring that we are testing people, even in rural areas. So our task is to protect people. And in doing so, we will do so clean and effectively.
But you have not done so clean and effectively. There's a 30 million rand PPE tender that's being investigated.
Let me tell you, don't want to push me to an issue which you have misconceived for yourself.
How have I misconceived it when you've confirmed that there is a 30 million rand PPE procurement that is being investigated?
When I go public and say there is so and so who have committed crime, don't then think that everyone have committed crime. I have mentioned people, individuals involved. Now you are coming and saying everyone have committed crime. That's what you have misconstrued, and you are wrong. Those who have done wrong must face music and must not be left unattended. But let's not blame everyone for that. There are people in the Department of Health who are very wrong. Among those are those who let Mr. Mkize to die in a tent. It is painful. But there are people in the Department of Health who goes an extra mile in serving our people. We must distinguish, deal with those who are wrong, but support those who are excelling in doing their work, who are going extra mile,
Why?
Who will do their service in a proper manner without being corrupt.
No, listen, we've been speaking for over 10 minutes. I've run out of time, but this is what bothers me about what you're saying. You're asking us to focus on you doing your job. You want a pat on the back for doing your job, but when we are raising concerns about corruption in your province, about a man dying, you're telling me I shouldn't deflect and not focus on the negative only. You have a responsibility as a public official to provide proper services for your citizens.
No, let me answer that. The first problem you are doing, there is someone who is ill-treating a patient. Then you are saying it is the MEC. I must go direct to say who have done this thing and deal with that person. And that's what we have done. There is a person who must conduct a procurement for PPEs. He goes, he inflates the price. He do orders without analyzing the need. I have gone to deal with that together with the respective MEC, suspended, and we are disciplining those people. We are going to continue acting with no fear or favor. But that does not mean it is happening throughout the province. It does not mean all hospitals are like what happened in Norte.
All right. Thank you for your time. KwaZulu-Natal Premier Sihle Zikalala. No, I'm done. Thank you so much. You've made your point.